Very good afternoon, students. What did we see in the previous class? Can anyone tell? Question number 57, Hemant.
In previous class, we have seen private branch.
Okay. Thank you, Suresh. Okay. Thank you, Pa. So, in today's class, we'll start with the next topic, paging systems. Well, you all know that it was used years earlier. So it's a kind of simplex communication that will be using the telephone line. The same concept as the cordless telephone, and also some pagers are available. Apart from that, we also had some kind of paging systems which will be used for the common announcements in an institution, or it could be any hospitals or any other organization where more people are getting working in different places and different rooms. So it is something like your intercoms in your classrooms in schools. You might have heard of that. Is they have intercoms in their there will be speaker in classrooms. And if at all the principal or head of the institution wants to communicate some information or anything to be communicated, they'll be using this kind of systems. So it is something like a one-way communication, simplex communications. So this is the simple diagram of the receiving pager. It's a simplex communication where images will be received here. Sorry, not images, the messages will be received here. So this pictorial representation is something similar to the one PA kind of a PA system, simplex communication that is also used for using the telephone line. So that is also one such example of a paging system. So now let us see in detail how this telephone line, the same telephone line, is used for sending the information or messages. Okay. So the paging systems are used to notify the subscriber of the need of a particular call that is being received to the telephone number, or to travel to a location to receive further instructions. So in more modern paging systems, there is news headlines, faxes can also be sent. That is the important information that is alone being communicated. So this pager, there is a kind of instrument that is handy. You can have it in our pocket and we can take it wherever we want within that coverage range. And this pager is a simplex communication device. And also we use paging systems. There are the communication systems that sends messages to the subscribers. So the message can be, it could be a numeric message or it could be alphanumeric message. So that is what we are going to convey with the help of the paging system and the pages. So the message sent to the paging subscriber via the paging system access the number with the telephone keypad or the modem. Okay, the telephone keypad or the modem, and the issued message is called to be the page. So normally it's a kind of a paging information message. So normally we call that as a page. So this paging system then transmits the page throughout the service area using the base stations, which broadcast the page on a radio carrier. So the coverage area of a simple paging system ranges from 2 to 5 kilometers, while a wide range paging system can have worldwide coverage. So depending upon the coverage range, we have to design the systems. Okay, if it is going to be a shorter distance communications, 2 to 5, and the corresponding transceivers will be used. And if it is going to be a longer range coverage, that is the worldwide coverage, it's going to be a corresponding devices will be used. So that is about the different paging systems. And when a sender wants to send a message to the receiver, he dials the particular number, the 10-digit pager number of the receiver through his telephone. So then this call is accepted by the operator present in the paging control center, to whom the receiver pager number and the message to be sent has to be sent. Okay. So then the operator will broadcast the message and the receiver to all the page numbers that has to be set. Okay, the paging number to all the paging terminals through the base stations. Okay, so this is how a broadcast info. So broadcast is nothing but one to many. So there will be one source, and from one source we want to broadcast the messages. So it's a kind of one-way communication. It is going to be a simplex communications. So the person who is receiving the message using the pager device will not be able to communicate back to the sender. But in some advanced pagers, the receiver could also communicate to, or send some message to the what is the sender by kind of acknowledgement. Oh, thank you, we have received the message. Some kind of positive acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement that we can send. So some advanced pages have that provision also. Okay. Next, then a particular base station under the area where the receiver is present will transmit the message to the corresponding receiver in the pager. So using the pager device, we will be reading the message. So whenever the message is received in that particular pager, an indication will be given by kind of beep sound. Okay, small beep sound will be there. Then the receiver receiver's pager device will receive all the messages and verify whether the sended message is stored in its memory or not. So if it is stored, then the pager device will give a beep sound. So only the identified number or the already known user will be able to send the messages. Okay, then if a known number is sending a message, then the message sent to the sender to his pager and the message will be displayed on the LCD screen. So some kind of authentication process will happen whether the person who is sending the message is a known person or not. So we have to register that particular pager to that particular base station. Okay, so this is how paging systems are functioning. So this is one such type called to be the pager. So this is a simple telephone paging system where the kind of institution having the reception office, upstairs office, you make use of the same telephone paging line, that telephone line, with the help of the telephone paging interface card, and there will be some kind of amplifiers through which we are sending the pages. That is, the pages means the information. Okay, so these pages could also be message in the form of alphanumeric information, or it could also be in the form of voice messages also. Voice messages also we can send. Something similar to your walkie-talkies, is it not? So that will be kind of loudspeakers. We will be simply sending the voice messages. So giving an alert. Okay, so it is it happens in kind of in the companies or in the build, I mean the institutions where so many people are working in different rooms or different floors. Everyone has to be communicated, some kind of emergency alert has to be given. So that could be done with the help of this paging system. Okay, so it could be a voice messages giving an alert, or if it is going to be a rich individual with the help of pager device also, we could receive the messages or something, nothing but the page. Okay, so that is about the telephone paging system. So what is a telephone paging system, to be more in specific? So in its simplest terms, the standard public address or the paging system consists of a microphone, amplifier, loudspeakers, if it is going to be a voice information. But the complexity of the zone paging and the paging from multiple locations can make use of the standard microphone, standard microphones, it's going to be quite complex. However, in most buildings, it is likely to find very handy microphones readily available in most rooms, or at least the close by in the form of telephone. So they make use of the telephone paging system itself instead of going for the complex devices using the amplifiers and loudspeakers as a separate units. They are going to make use of the already available telephone systems. So therefore, this telephone paging systems replace standard paging mics with the standard desktop phones, either via the telephone paging interface or in many cases via the telephone input, often found in the professional, that is the PA amplifiers. That is the public addressing amplifiers. There will be an amplifier unit. Always the public addressing systems which have the mic and the speakers, they will be having amplifier unit, is it not? Which will be the mic will be terminated at this amplifier, and from the amplifier it will be going to the speaker. So that will be amplifier unit. So whenever you wanted to boost up the audio signal, this amplifiers will be helping to do that. So this kind of paging systems are being developed with the help of the same, the telephone number, telephone lines itself. Okay, so that is about the paging systems. So coming to the pagers, so these pagers operate as part of the paging system, which includes one or more fixed transmitters, or in case of response pagers, or two-way pagers also, or one or more base stations. So in case of response pagers means it's going to be a simplex communication. Two-way pages means, as I told you, the receiver also will be able to send some kind of acknowledgement messages. as well as a number of pages carried by mobile users. So it is very handy. So these pages will be very handy. We can have it in our hand and you can take it on the mobile, which means that we can take it wherever we want it to go. Some kind of pages, they will be having it in their pockets, is it not? So that is called to be the pager device. So these systems can range from the restaurant system with a single low power transmitter. So you would have seen some kind of paging systems, that is the pager systems that is available in the restaurants, is it not? So that is what is a person, there will be a person who is taking the menu card, mean getting the details from the customers, and he will be noting it down. And from the person, the one who is doing that, getting the data and entering it in the device, and that will be transmitted to the person, the chef, who is available at the kitchen. Okay, so they are sending some kind of information. Okay, so that system is also a simple example of a paging system. So they'll be using a small kind of transmitter, low power transmitter unit. So within that hotel or the restaurant range, okay, they will be making use of this paging systems. So that will be, nowadays they make use of the advanced devices with the help of Wi-Fi connection. But in olden days, these pages were also used for sending these kind of informations. Okay, so for that, so it has lot of applications, but still many places, these kind of pages are also used because it is of low cost compared to the your Wi-Fi connection and the advanced mobile devices which are used for sending this kind of information. Okay, so these pages are used for low power transmission within a particular area. And if at all you wanted to have a wide coverage area like nationwide systems with the thousands of high power base stations, that is for longer distance communications. Okay, so that kind of paging systems and pages are also available in the market, which many people are using. Okay, so this is about the pagers in the paging system. So these how these pagers have evolved. So these pagers were developed in the 1950s and 60s and became widely used in the years 1980s before the evolution of this cellular phones in late, I suppose it is 1990s and 2000. Okay, around that year only we had they have introduced. I happened to experience them the making use of the cellular mobile phones, older telephones, bigger telephones in the year I think it's 2000, I suppose. Okay, and even at that time we were not allowed to use, but we happened to see that kind of cellular telephones. Okay, so in the 21st century, the widespread availability of cellular telephones and the smartphones had greatly diminished the pager industry. So with the evolution of this advanced cellular telephones, the usage of pagers have also diminished. Nevertheless, these pagers continue to be used in some emergency services. So even though it has lost its craze in the market of people market, market in the people for the use of this pagers in the by the people, but for some emergency services and public safety personnel, and because modern pager systems they have a coverage overlap and the combined usage of satellite communications as well, we can make the paging systems more advanced. Okay, so apart from the cellular telephones, even though we tell that the usage of pagers have diminished, but still some of the applications they make use of these paging systems with the intervention of the satellite communication systems, as well as some kind of reliable terrestrial based cellular networks, and in some cases including the natural and man-made disaster situations where mobile and cellular tower phones will go off. In such cases, they will make use of these paging systems. So the same technology, they will be using it for your satellite telephones. Okay, so have you heard of the satellite telephones where the signal, whichever location we wanted to go in around the world, you will be given a unique identification number and you'll be able to communicate with the people who are having registered to that satellite telephones. So it is something similar to that. So they are making use of these satellite communications around the worldwide. Okay, so this resilience has led the public safety agencies to adopt pages covered apart from the cellular and other commercial for critical messaging. So these public safety agencies like your fire services, and if you wanted to give a panic alert to the of the flood and of any emergency situations, of any earthquake, and there is a Phoenix seismic record has been predicted, and if it has to be alerted to the public, they make use of this kind of pages. Okay, so these pages will be helpful. So there will be some local base station will be there. They will be giving alert and sending messages to the people who are at the base station, and from there many people will be given alert to that particular locality. So this is how the paging systems were used. Okay, so that is about the paging system. So this is one such example of the paging device that is used. So it is going to be the simple paging receiver. So that is all about the paging system. We created this quiz for the subject communication systems, and to be more specific for the telephone communication systems. So some of the questions and the topics we have discussed. So what are the topics we have discussed so far? Can anyone summarize? Pranita has said the different types of telephones. Types of telephones, paging systems, cordless telephones, very good. Then PBX, introduction to telephones, FCC, very good, electronic telephone, FCC, SS7, standard telephone, electronic telephone, cordless telephone, digital analog, telephone hierarchy, SLIC,
fax machine.
Hari Pranay?
Fax machine, ma'am.
Fax machine, yeah. Very good. Other than that, tip and the ring, fax machine, cordless telephones, FCC paging, cellular telephones. Yes. Cellular telephone we have not seen so far. We'll be seeing it in the next class. Bosch, local loop. Yeah. So what I wanted you to do is, can you all open a web browser? If you are using laptop, it is well and good. Even if you are using your mobile phone, please open a web browser. Chat box you enable, sir. Please open the web browser. Open the web browser. So it's going to be something interesting. So are you all able to see my web browser? Have you opened? Okay. So
yes, ma.
Thank you. In that, you go and type www.kahoot.it. Are you able to open the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Okay, ma'am. Okay, I'm going to launch that. Yes. So this is the game pin. Please type the game pin.
Okay.
And log in with your name. Now it is going to be a practice session only. You can log in with any name. Log in. Very good. Thank you. 48, 51 players are here. 53, 54. Very good. Boys, come on. Students. Again, please type kahoot.it, www.kahoot.it. So, we wanted you to get familiarized with this tool. That is why we are making a try. please join www.kahoot.it. Even you can download this Kahoot app in your mobile, because this is where we are. This one we are going to use it frequently for all the online sessions for all the subjects. So you can even download the Kahoot app in your mobile. So how it is going to be mixed? Let me mute the audio. Okay, how it is going to be mixed? This question will be displayed on the screen. I will be posting the question, and only the options, the objective type options, will be there on your screen. Okay, and you have to select. So we'll see how it is going to work out. So okay, before launching each and every question, let me tell you that I'm going to launch the particular question, and you have to look at the question on the screen and select the answer. Okay, are you able to do it? Can anyone respond? Please join. You can join at www.kahoot.it. Then it will be asking for the game pin, and then you have to log in with your name. Yes. Okay. Shall we start, or only 122 players have joined? Students have joined. Lokitya, Wingert. Yes, we'll start. 125 mean others are not interested, I suppose, or make it facilitated at your in your laptop or your mobile. Okay, I'll start. Okay, so it is going to be the communication systems. The first question to you is, what does DTMF stand for? So you will be given 30 seconds. Choose the answers. I'm receiving answers. What does DTMF stand for? The time is up. Yes, that is 48 students have answered it correctly. Very good. Remaining people, make a tie. So what is DTMF? DTMF stands for dual tone multi frequency. So this is the correct answer. Do you understand, students? Is it clear to everyone? Are you getting comfortable with this tool? Please respond. Please unmute yourself and respond.
Here, unmute your yes, ma'am.
Yes, are you comfortable with this tool? Yes, okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we go ahead with the next question?
Obviously, ma'am.
Yes, yes. The next question is, so that it shows the high person who has answered very quickly. Okay, so based on that, the scoring will be there. So it's going to be a fun activity. Don't worry that it is going to be validated or something like that. Okay. Matthew has answered very quickly. Next, followed by Shruti, Uday Kumar, and Karthik. We'll go to next. Second question, PSTN. What does PSTN stand for? Your time starts now. Let's have some music. Many people are sleeping. What is LATA? This topic I think we had discussed yesterday. LATA. Local access and transport area. Very good. What is the latter? Next question. Local loops terminate at, I think this most of you would answer it correctly, I suppose. Local loops terminate at tandem office, central office, toll station, or inter exchange office. Of you have answered it. First question. In telephony, what does POP stand for? Protocol that is used in the signaling network is called, I think this also most of you would answer, the protocol that is used in the signaling network is called, so it's a kind of practice. Okay, next question is, the cordless telephone using the frequencies for transmission in the base station and the portable unit, the different frequencies. So that kind of communication is known as there is the usage of separate frequencies for the transmission and there is the base station and the portable unit. Yes, it is going to be the duplex arrangement. 31 of you have answered it correctly. Which of the following is the drawback for cordless telephones? I think this most of you would answer it correctly, I suppose. Last question. The cable used for the local loops is mainly thank you. 71 of you have answered it correctly. Very good. So it is going to be the cable used for local loops is mainly the twisted pair of copper wire. Now let us see who is the topper here. The final conclusion. 7 out of 10. Pranita. Marty. Very good. So the third position goes to Pranita. She has answered 7 correct questions. So it might be the mistake one which I have validated also. And the Hema has answered 7 out of 10. So that is the tie. So based on the time, it is calculated. Karthik is the top one. So it's going to be a kind of fun activity. So hereafter, we'll be conducting the quiz for all the main subjects in the same way in the Kahoot app. So are you comfortable with the Kahoot app? Please respond to this question in the chat box, or if you can unmute also, you can unmute and answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Comfortable?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am.
So, do you need little more time for analyzing the answer to
yes,
the question?
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Currently, no, we ma'am. Have no.
No, ma'am.
Excellent work, ma'am.
Currently,
no, ma'am.
We have.
No,
currently,
ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Main problem, blah blah.
Okay, currently we have, what is that? I have set 30 seconds for analyzing. Is it enough or we need some more time? 40 minutes. Put it in the chat box, ma'am, please. Okay, 45 is better. Narasimha has done. So we'll take it to 40. Okay, many of you suggested 40 plus. 15 seconds is enough. Muhammad Imran, not everyone can respond like you, Muhammad Imran. Okay, we need more time for analyzing. Yeah, I understand. Seconds is enough. Okay, Imran. Okay. Okay, we'll go with the 40 seconds. Okay, not too, I mean, long and not too less. Okay. So, any more questions here? So, we'll prepare with some more questions in the next, coming week. And please go through the contents, whatever we have learned so far. Whatever we have discussed in the class. So please, whenever this quiz is conducted, please try to log in with your laptop. So that would be more comfortable for you. Huh? And more easy for you to understand, because in mobile, means you have to switch over from the web browser to the Zoom, because the question will be in the Zoom platform and answer you have to answer in the browser. Yeah, yeah. Next time the prior date, I will say when you will be conducting the quiz. So be prepared in your laptop. So that would be easy for you to understand. So it is not something you to hurt you or something like that. So those who have answered it incorrectly, it is the time and platform for you to know the correct answer. Okay, you can so a correct answer will be validated at the end. You can learn. So it's going to be a kind of fun activity at the same time for learning purpose. Let me give a quick summary of whatever topics we have covered. Okay. Please, if you have any doubts, raise questions. So this quiz also carries mark, ma. Okay, for your internal marks. So that is what important is. Now it is a practice, but finally, the day we will announce which will be conducting quiz for unit number 1 and unit number 2. Before that, practice quiz will be conducted. So the questions will be based on that, and that is considered for your internal marks, as you are known. Okay. So please be prepared for that. So it's a kind of smart way of learning. Okay. So these are the topics of the first unit. So we started with the telephones, interaction, standard telephone, local loop, then electronics telephone, cordless telephone, the Bosch functions are very, very important, and the fax machine operation, and the finally paging systems. Okay. So we have covered all these topics so far. In the subsequent classes in the next week, we will learn about the cellular telephone and ISDN. Okay. Do you have any doubt? Assignments are, yeah, assignments, as far as your assignment is considered, we'll post the assignment on the day of, on 31st. Assignment for you, you have to submit the assignment. Deadline date is 8th. Okay, ma? Deadline date is 8th. So, assignment, it is going to be, what is that? Let me tell you the details of assignment. Assignment, 15 marks, 1-5. 15 marks is allocated for assignment. So, 5 fill in the blanks or multiple choice questions, each carry 1 mark. So, 5 marks there. Okay, I repeat, assignment, total marks is 15 marks. 5 filling the blanks and multiple choice questions, each carrying 1 mark, so totally 5 marks. Then we'll have 5 short questions, 5 marks. Okay, 5 short questions, each one 1 mark, so totally 5 marks, 5 plus 5, 10. And 1 long question, it is going to be 5 marks, so totally 15 marks. So it is going to be 3 sections, that is the first one is filling the blanks or multiple choice questions, second one is 5 short questions, and the third one is 1 long question. So each carrying each section carrying 5 marks, so totally 15 marks. Okay, so it will be posted in the LMS, and for the people who are not able to log into the LMS, we'll come back to you what is the way to submit the assignment. So the assignment will be posted on 31st, and you will have to submit the assignment on 8th September. Okay, are you clear with the concept? Okay, and the quizzes will be conducted, which is considered for validation of the marks, on 18th and 19th September. So that will announce you prior. So before that, during the regular class hours also, we will conduct practice quizzes. Okay, so be prepared with that.